You've been praying about something for a while, and you haven't seen God move yet. And the enemy wants to go, you don't have enough faith. The enemy wants to go, you're doing something wrong, and God is mad at you, and that's why he hasn't shown up supernaturally in your life. God's not mad at you. You need to know that God can move in the supernatural moment of miracle, but he can also move powerfully in the everyday. And God wants to move in your everyday. He sees your need. He sees your faith. And he's working things out for your good. Don't take on a burden of condemnation that you don't have enough faith. Understand that God works in a lot of different ways. So that's one way we could get in the ditch. But I have to talk about this other way. Here's the other way that concerns me more. I think it impacts us more. We've lost our wonder for the goodness of God. I mean, how big of a miracle is it when somebody has been addicted and in bondage and enslaved and Jesus comes in and rescues them out and puts their feet on solid ground and gives them salvation and life and healing, and we see that happen. We go, oh yeah, somebody got saved. No, it's more than that. For them, it's everything. We can't lose our wonder. We can't lose our gratitude for God's goodness in our life. How about this? How about two healthy churches in the city of Tulsa who decide that it's God's will that they come together, which has happened here? You think that's not a miracle? You think that happens every day? That doesn't happen every day. I know, I've been around the church my whole life. What has happened between Solace and Glenpool Church on the Move is unbelievable. It's remarkable. And I know because I saw the leaders of Glenpool and I saw the leaders of Solace come with humility and say, we want to do what God wants to do. Man, no church is like that. Churches are petty. Churches have agendas. Churches have identities that they don't want to let go. Not this church. We cannot lose our awe and our wonder of what God is doing that is so good in our midst.